Today is Tuesday, the 22nd of the 2nd, 22. It's a date that's both a palindrome, meaning it reads the same backwards, and also an ambigram, meaning it reads the same upside down.
Is the fastest. This is what we call manifestation on steroids.
22222 portal.
You can use it to change your life.
Cherish today because it's a mathematical rarity. It happens only once in a lifetime. It's the 22nd of the 2nd, 2022. It's a palindrome. 22nd of the 2nd, 2022. A palindrome. But there's something else as well. It's not just a palindrome. It's also an ambigram. And it's probably a clue on Wordle, that, isn't it? Which means that it reads the same upside down as it does the other way up. And it also reads the same if you see it in a mirror.
For today is too legit to quit Tuesday.
Manifest the life that you've always wanted.
Very good. I was excited because it was exactly 22 degrees at 2:22 in Melbourne today.
Oh,
yep.
Wow.
It was not in Sydney where it was stormy.
Happy birthday to me. Happy birthday to the world. And happy birthday to special people. My message is very simple. 22022022. And play it back again any way you want it. This is how it is. But what is the news? Today brings you the biggest story ever, that the Ark, some people call it the Noah's Ark, is going to be outdoor. So watch it now and subscribe. Boom.
Be inspired. Be innovative. Be creative. Be a nation's builder. Watch Zoe TV and The Wood Magician now.
Zoe TV.
Zoe TV.
Zoe TV.
Zoe TV, you know, worldwide, you know what I'm saying?
Greetings, Tony Asha, coming to you from Ghana, West Africa. Yeah, man, it's been a long journey, you know. Why, it's nice to know some escape Babylon. Right, it's been years in the making, and eventually I've arrived. Happy, right? Reborn. Oh, only John knew how I feel right now, brethren.
Sometimes I wonder who built the first ark.
The ark is a biblical construction going back to the Old Testament. I think that was the time Noah was being commanded, I mean, to build such a type of ark so that he can rescue humankind. That is the short description of it. And the story behind it is quite impressive. So when I came here, I went to the toilet. I saw the ark, I said, what? And I went to the inscription on the wall. I said, wow. You know, it's so wonderful for me. So to be frank, even I wanted to find out where the ark.
I'm in the ark. They found the boat. Yeah. Sailed on the Nile, you know. It's a beautiful build. Yeah, boy, I can't really express how I feel right now, you know. Can't express it, just joy.
I found the ark, and it's located before Ashalibote School, Janshe. And the place is so good. The service is amazing. I really loved it. I think it is a new place in town that everybody should visit, you know? Like, everybody should try and see a visit to the place. You'll love it. Like, I know the Noah's Ark. And I've been wondering the concept behind the Ark, you know. I don't understand, but I see it has something of like a pirate, shipman or something. And the witches dress like, they are, how do they call them? Like the captains of the ship. Like, they are so funny and nice. You love it.
The ark is. Let me see if I can find the words for it. It's a creation of imagination. And right now, Mr. Tizozo, you know, it's like spiritual imagination.
My name is Fanisa Ademola. My experience about the ark is a very different. Because the first ark that I know is the Noah's ark. And I've got to think about it, like, how somebody could build something like this in this kind of environment.
There are flood stories everywhere from ancient times, especially when you start to read about Kemet, Egypt as today we call it. I'm looking at this. It takes me to the story of floods in Egypt. The Nile has a story. But the people that settle around the Nile that have moved to West Africa, we have a story too.
The Ark is a representation of our ancient ancestors who sailed on the Nile to West Africa, Ghana. Ashali Boutwe in this story is chosen to be the home of the early boat settlers. In 2021, as in the middle of the pandemic of COVID, Zozo and his crew did a restoration and a resurrection project by giving birth to a new boat, which signifies rescue of humanity and the times in which we are, just as with what happens in the ancient times with the flood.
The Ark Restaurant and Bar, it's where we are now. We are asked to perform here on Friday. Yeah, that's last week Friday. And I was amazed when I came out because I've never seen such a place like this in Ghana before. The way that the building has been structured and its natural environment makes it a very nice place for you to just come to hang around. It's a very cool place. With this one, the Ark makes it unique because there's nothing like its kind in Ghana here.
I came to perform with a live band. It's called Classic Groove Band, and it's been an amazing time. This is the Ark Restaurant, such a lovely place. Great food, great music, it's unique. I mean, the Ark has a ring to it. I don't think I'll ever forget the name of this restaurant.
The story of Noah is an interesting story. The story of Pharaoh Khufu is an interesting story. And the story of Tutankhamun is an interesting story. I am going down.
Hello, hi, my name is Asari Ajay. I'm here at the Ark, an amazing place, a creative achievement, a genius level creative achievement by the good magician himself, Zozo. It's brilliant architecture, handmade from pallets, you know, recycled it, and used with just sheer brilliance and creativity. And the Ark is just an amazing place that everyone in Ghana, everyone in Accra needs to come and see. It's amazing. And then the atmosphere always great here. Really cool vibes, good people, really fun time. And yeah, it's a great place, man. And the building and the construction and the work that Zozo has done is just amazing. Just brilliant.
There is something very mystic about the Ark in Ghana. That mysticism is what I am wondering about. I never plan to build an ark, and I never plan to build a boat. It all happened by chance.
It felt good to first conceive the idea, and everything seemed very easy from the beginning, but along the line, complications came in. There were a few up and down, disappointments, but the most interesting thing about the whole project, for me, is at every point in time, we conceive new ideas.
Well,
like I said, it was something we didn't conceive to be this big. It was something we just wanted to occupy this small space with a wooden structure.
Mm-hmm.
And we didn't even know that it would come out to be a ship or a boat or anything of this form. It's just a wooden structure we want to have. And first, the initial plan was just to have the ground floor. And then idea came like, oh, why won't we just raise it? Because you may have a lot of people coming in and you wouldn't have enough sitting area or places for people. And then boom, here we are with the upper deck and then the ground floor and even enough sitting area outside. So yes, we didn't conceive it to be this big, but here we are today.
Yeah.
Either the Khufu's Ark, either the Tutankhamun's Ark, either the Noah's Ark has reincarnated itself in Ghana. Yeah, the Ark has a big story around. And I would like to tell you at least the story of the Ark now. It took us about 6 months to build the Ark. And it took us 6 months to build the Ark because everything happened on site. It wasn't something that was thought through. It wasn't something that was planned. So in the process of redrawing things and making sure that we can hit target, it took us about 6 months to complete the Ark project. It was never gonna be called the Ark. The original name is Aquavine. But something else happened on the way and it has to be called the Ark. That is how the people saw it. People that walk around, people that came by, people that saw the building couldn't have anything to say than to call it the Ark. What wood was used to build the Ark? The Ark has been built by waste wood, reclaimed wood from all over the world. So I have to give life to a dead wood. Do you see? That is the first rescue mission. You give life to a dead wood. You give life to something that was not meant or was not thought through or was never part of a thinking process that it could be used. So the Ark has been built by waste wood. 95% of the construction of the Ark is waste wood. 5% Ghanaian wood. Because of this, we want to be able to give back to the world. When you go to the top of the Ark, when you go inside there, you will see that there are about 8 walls, and it's a wall that talks about humans, animals, countries, almost everything that you can think about, they are on the wall. They are all part of the journey. They are all part of the transformation. They are all part of the movement to make Africa great again. The primary builders of the Ark in Ghana are 3 little apprentices with no skills at all in carpentry. They were the one with me that built the entire Ark. I mean, yes, credit goes to my electricians, credit goes to my plumber, you know, and all other third parties that came in. Can you imagine? It tells you the story of creation. It tells you the story of where we need to go. So that means that everything on the continent is doable. Everything is achievable. This is what lifestyle creation, freedom nation builders are bringing on board. The Ark in Ghana now has a modern and an ancient look to it. If you see the Ark, it will tell you a story that has been there for a very long time. Our Ark has been tilted 1 inch off. Just to tell the story that I have been here for so many years now. Signifies transformation, signifies Africa to the next level, signifies technology and industrialization. Great thanks to almost everybody that was behind me, that supported me for this ARC to be built. It wasn't an easy journey like that, but we made it happen, and it is the new talk of the town. The new talk of the town is gonna be the new talk of the continent, is gonna be the new talk of the world.